Hey guys, it's Danny. Welcome back to Creepy Crafty Days here on my channel where I'm sharing a video every single day this month. Today I'm sharing a little mini album. Actually, it's kind of a big mini album that I've made recently and I wanted to flip you guys through it. So I have not really put any goodies in here yet just because I want it to still be kind of a surprise for my pen pal that I'm sending it to. But I'll go ahead and just flip you guys through it really quick. It took forever to make, so that's why there's not a process video on it and just a project share. So I hope that's okay with you guys. So it's held closed with this like elastic that I just hot glued this really cute bow onto. This bow is from Serena B's shop over at Paper Cakes, which I will leave a link to down below. So you just take this off and that's what holds the album closed. There's a glitter spider on the front as well as on the back. I actually got the idea for this style of mini album from Tori over at Tori Bissell. So I'll leave a link to her channel down below. And this is basically an envelope style of mini album. Mine is really big and chunky. Hers was not so chunky, but I went a little bit crazy just having fun making this. So I made the covers out of chipboard, and then each of the pages, here I'll show you this way maybe. So let's see, so this is like an envelope. This is an envelope, this is an envelope, this is an envelope. And these are the kinds of envelopes I use. So they're 6-inch square black envelopes. And so what I did was for every page to make it kind of an accordion style, I took this little like strip thing off and put some more glue on there. And then I took a second envelope and I adhered it down like that. Right? And then, so this was all kind of combined, and then I just repeated the process. So I put, you know, more glue here and then another envelope so that it would make kind of like an accordion style. If you guys want to see more kind of close up step by step of how to actually construct it, definitely go check out Tori's channel. I'll try to find her video and link it down below for you guys so you can have a better idea of how it's all actually constructed. So I used a variety of papers from my stash as well as paper cake papers and embellishments. Papers and embellishments from the Beautiful Nights collection, and I really just did try to shop my stash for this whole thing. So when you first open it like this, there's like this little bag thing here that has a little pullout deal for like a photo or something on there. The back has room for journaling and another photo, and then that just slides right in there. And I decorated the front with some paper cakes cards and washi, and then flips like that. And I've had this orange glitter like alphas in my stash for a couple of years now, I think. So it was time to use them, so I put them right there. I think this paper might be from, I don't know, I think it's from Doodlebug maybe, or I'm not sure. It's from last year and I can't really remember the collection, I'm sorry. So this is just matted on there. This is what this spread looks like. And what I tried to do throughout for the little frames that I cut out, I just adhered them down with a bit of washi tape so that my pen pal can like cut out a photo the correct size, just kind of mount it back there and then finish gluing this down. So I thought that would be kind of cool. This is spooky. There's a little spot for journaling and a doily, lots of little gemmies throughout. This looks like there's also a bunch of flippy bits, which I think are fun. This is a pocket that I'm gonna put a, some goodies in for my pen pal. This is a little paper clip I made. So yeah, I mean, there's just like a lot of flippies. There's like little hidden photos, which I think is fun. They could put like a big picture here if they want. I don't know. I thought it was just kind of fun to go ahead and put some frames in and let them kind of figure out what pictures they wanted to put in. And what's really cool about this album is that there are 31 like pages for putting pictures or journaling or souvenirs or whatever. So if my pen pal wanted to use this for October daily one year, they could. This is like a little pocket. I made this little tag. I made this little paper clip. Yeah, and then this just opens and I haven't put anything in there yet. And then what's really cool is you flip the back over, right? And then you open it again and it's like more album, which I think is really fun, you know? I don't know, I just love it. I think it's so cool how this turned out. And like my pen pal could display it if they wanted to because it will stand up on its own, which I think is fun. So I'm really excited for my pen pal to get this. I'm like so enthused about this whole like album. I almost like don't wanna send it. I kinda wanna keep it for myself, but that's like, super greedy, so I'm not gonna do that. So this is like a little envelope, and I glued a card down over the like the flap of it. So it's like that, so it can hold like tickets or whatever in there. They can journal or put a photo there. These little purple like glitter alphas I've had forever in my stash, so I just used some Tombow glue to adhere those down. This is like a little slip pocket or whatever. I don't know, you guys. I think this is so cool. I love this album so much. I really want to make another one, but dang if it didn't take forever. So it might be a little while before I make one this giant, but yeah, I will definitely be making more of these because it's so fun. Yeah, so this is the last page, and then there's a couple of like little pockets here so they can put in, I don't know, tags or more photos or like, I don't know, private journaling or whatever they want to do, so that can do that. And you can see like the edge of the envelope here. So that's what it looks like. And then you can start all over if you wanted to. So that is it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed this flip through of a fun mini album that I created. Make sure you guys are sharing your creepy crafty creations by using the hashtag #CreepyCraftyDays when you share it, so that I can see it and everyone else can see it. Make sure to share it in our Facebook group, which I'll link down below, as well as on Instagram using the hashtag, and I might just repost it on the Instagram. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye! Thank you for joining me today for Creepy Crafty Days. If you missed yesterday's video, you can click here to watch it. If you'd like to start the playlist over, you can click right here. And if you'd like to subscribe, of course, why wouldn't you? You can click right here. I'd love to have you guys follow along. Thank you again so much for watching today's video, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye!